Socrates. Now, Socrates is considered as father of Western philosophy. Hello friends, today we are going to have a discussion on another philosopher, that is Socrates. Now, Socrates is considered as father of Western philosophy. Interestingly, he has not written anything and he was being executed by the state on the charges that he is diverting and corrupting the young minds. So his philosophy and his teachings were really controversial. He was speaking and philosophizing in Athens. So we know that Athens is a place where it is being claimed that democracy has emerged. Now, in a place where democracy has come up, now whom we consider as a father of Western philosophy, he had to give up on his life for saying and talking about truth and justice. Later on, after his death, his students, friends, and specifically Plato, was really got sad and definitely got into a depression because of his death. Now, Plato took responsibility for making Socrates' ideas famous to the world. So guys, when we are understanding philosophers, make sure you are not only reading them for the sake of your competitive examination such as UPSC. You do have to understand their ideas in a manner that can help you in ethics, essay, GS1, or maybe in your interview. Largely, I believe that you must learn about their ideas that can help you to become a good human. Now, what was his crucial point which actually disturbed the hegemony or the state? He was actually questioning the norms of powerful people. Socrates' idea was controversial and it actually challenged the teachings of Sophists. Later on, we'll know who were Sophists. Briefly, I tell you that Sophists are intellectual people considered in Athens who used to charge money and they used to teach and educate people. So these people had the philosophy that there cannot be an absolute truth, and for them the truth resides with power. Now Socrates has a actually really problem with this point. We'll discuss this. Socrates questioned at that point of time to the philosophy of justice, and Socrates' method is known as Elenchus method. This is a really interesting method which he deployed at his time. So what is Elenchus method? Elenchus method is about initiating a dialogue with a critical or tricky questions. I will explain how in coming slides when I'm going to talk about his method. As I have said, it is integral for us to know their philosophy. So we can summarize in few lines about Socrates' philosophies that he was talking about universal truth. He was talking about that how to maintain stability in society, we need to have moralistic principles. So let's have a quick discussion on Socrates. So this is a period where Socrates So this is the period 470 to 399 BC. Okay. And he was born here in this point. Now, we know that he is considered as the father of Western philosophy. He never wrote down anything. So his ideas got famous by his student Plato. Okay. So in coming lectures, we are also going to read about Plato. So as I was saying that Socrates' ideas was actually disturbed the ideas and the philosophies of sophists. So who were sophists? Let's understand this. So sophists were intelligent men who traveled from place to place teaching subjects like grammar, rhetoric, arguments and literature. So we know that how the education used to spread all over the world at a time where there was no technology, there was no schools, there was no formal schools. So the travelers were the one who used to bring not only cultural information, but they used to debate about philosophy as well. So sophists were, you can say, largely travelers, okay, and intelligent men. So Athens was an emerging democratic center and educated people were needed. So now these sophists in Athens, they charged for their services, usually employed by the wealthy and powerful. So you can see that even at that point of time, and I think it is partially correct too, if you'll talk about Louis Althusser, he's a contemporary philosopher. Okay, and he's also talking about that how even philosophy education is controlled by wealthy people. Similar viewpoint we can also have understanding from Pierre Bourdieu and lot many other philosophers. However, now at that point of time when we are talking about Socrates, similar circumstances we can see. So the philosophers or the educated people used to work for these wealthy people. And now these wealthy people used to pay them salary for producing a kind of knowledge, actually what they wanted. But this was not ultimately true for all the philosophers. We know that history have got highest esteemed and honest philosophers as well. So Socrates was one of them. Now let's quickly see what was their philosophy. So sophists were concerned with individuals and individuals' place. And what they used to say that truth and justice were products of habits and circumstances. Okay, so justice is simply the interest of the stronger. So we cannot simply have a clear distinction between goods and evil. So कोई भी चीज morally ना ही सही है ना ही वो गलत है. So we cannot actually differentiate that. So these are the points. So man is the major of all the things, right? So man is the major of all things, led to the belief that the differences between good and evil cannot be known. And this was actually a divergence to, you can see, a divorce have majorly have taken place in Socrates' idea. Socrates did talk about universal truth. Okay, so this what we can say. So truth was not the most important issue, but rather the ability to pursue your audience of the truth of your position. So it created, sophist philosophy created tensions in Athens. They suggested there were no absolute norms for right or wrong. And this actually contributed breakdown in moral order. Now, as we know that we cannot have any distinction between good and evil as per sophist, and he could argue that best won out. And Socrates actually did not like this point. So what was Socrates' ideas? Okay. Socrates was concerned with the questions of ethics, that is moral behavior. Unlike the sophist, he believed that there was definite right and wrong. He believed that people could accept it and apply it into their daily lives. He said that it was up to people, that's in society as a whole, to establish those things that are right and those that are wrong. Now, you can say that he was searching for some standard rules and regulation which can bring stability in society. Now, I'm coming to that same point, Eleanor's method, Socrates' method, which I call, and everyone find it really interesting. So what he used to do, while his style was distinctive, he used to question people through discussions or dialogues. He chose people who were experts in their field and who fully understood the topic being discussed. He adopted the role of ignorant questioner, pretended he did not know and wanted to be educated. He asked tactful questions, which would bring the expert to a dead end. They would run out of answers. They showed them and others that they did not have all the answers and so were not experts. So therefore, the aim of this method was to get to the truth of how a person could live a good and moral life. So dialogues argued people to question what has been told to them. He learned through this process and developed his own philosophy from this method. Now let's have some discussion on this method. So Socrates have used this method to bring out the inner reality of people while using and having dialogues with people. For instance, Socrates used to go to the marketplace, okay, and there he used to choose people who are known to be as experts in their fields, and then in a very tricky manner he used to ask questions. For instance, there was a contemporary called Cephalus. He asked Cephalus, he said yes. And he said that, how do you feel now to be old? Cephalus replied that, yeah, I'm good. I don't have any more desires. I can have my peace and not urge, and I'm living my life peacefully. Then Socrates asked again, so Cephalus, tell me, do you have an urge for sex? Cephalus said, what? Then, you know, I'm just telling you the whole conversation. It is mentioned in Plato's work. So he said, at this stage, Socrates, I don't think so that I or anyone must have urge for sex. Then, you know, Socrates was laughing, was smiling and said, no, tell me, do you have an urge for sex now? He says, no, I have a control of my desires. Now I've got a wisdom over it. Then Socrates asked another question to Cephalus. He said, Cephalus, do you know about justice? Cephalus said, justice is doing right action. As I have told that in the PPT, that how Socrates used to show while having conversation as if that he didn't know anything. So he just made a picture or an impression towards Cephalus that he wants to know more about justice. So Cephalus replied that when we are doing right behavior to others, that is a justice. Then another tricky question came from Socrates. Socrates says, okay, Cephalus, imagine you have a friend and that friend is very close to you. And your friend has given a I'm just telling you, like, you know, the point. I do not know whether they have talked about the sword or what was the actual instrument they have used, but I'm just telling you the sword. He says, just imagine you had a friend and he had given that sword to you to keep it for some time. What will you do? He said, I will keep it. And whensoever he'll ask, will you return it? Sephiroth said, definitely yes, I would. Then Socrates put another question to Sephiroth, that now imagine you will come to know that your friend is now under depression. He is having anxiety issues and probably he can kill himself. Now, if that friend comes to visit you and wants to have that sword or revolver back from you, will you give him? He said, no, I will not. Then Socrates said, but then you are not doing justice to him, because ultimately that revolver or sword belongs to your friend. Then Sepphoris again said, I know the condition, he might hurt himself, so I do not want to hurt him, I will not give. Then Sepphoris asked again, then what is a justice? You are not doing justice, you are not giving the point. He says that he got confused at what to reply now, because earlier he said that definitely he would give his sword better. So the moral of the story is, we can talk about morality, but there are circumstances attached to it. We cannot just simply have some basic rules which would say that, okay, now I would just give the revolver because it is of, like, you know, that of friend, and I do not care whether he will hurt himself or not, I can't do anything. So we can actually have some sort of flexibility with respect to morality. So there has to be a moral good and bad. So morality, universal morality. No matter what, ultimately, which fundamental aspect should win in society? That is humanity. This is what Socrates is trying to tell to the world. So this is an important point. And this is just not the one scenario where he used to ask questions. He used to ask questions on highly controversial and philosophical points. And then he used to debate. Okay, so this is one of the points or one of the discussion which Socrates has made with respect to justice. Another important point was for Socrates, it was soul. Soul means consciousness. So ultimately your consciousness will guide you what is correct or wrong. Okay, so it is not something that these philosophers' ideas or understanding we cannot apply in our lives. Ultimately your actions will tell you, you know, your soul or your subconscious will tell you how your actions are. Kisi ko pata ho ya na ho, aapko pata hota hai aapke actions. Okay, so this is what Socrates have asked, that we can create a wonderful society. Human has the maximum potential to make such rules, norms, which can bring happiness to the world. Morality should be a common universal principle to decide which type of laws we can have in our society. As I have said, that another important point which philosophers, almost all the philosophers have talked about, all the sociologists have talked about, it's about morality. It's all about truth. What is truth? So we know that our conscience can guide us, that if we are doing this action, is it bringing a larger peace or good to our society or not? Or if we are victim of our own desires, are we being selfish? And as we know that if we want to improvise, it cannot be just one day event. You need to work hard. You need to always contemplate. This is what Socrates' philosophy is teaching us. We need to see whether we are doing something good or bad. And every day we should endeavor to bring some good in us. This is what actually philosophy teaches us, right? So he simply says that soul or the consciousness has to be nurtured and protected. You know, this is what Gautam Buddha have also talked about. Every philosophers have talked about. Gandhiji, everyone is talking about the same. All the religious textbooks are talking about the same. Humanity, goodness, you know, consciousness cannot come easily. You have to sacrifice. What we have to sacrifice? Ego, anger, you know, competition with each other. Not many greeds we have to sacrifice. सबसे ज्यादा मैं मेरी जरूरत, मैं जो चाहता हूँ या चाहती हूँ, मैं मेरी डिजायर्स ये है, मैं मेरी जो डिमांड्स है वो सबसे ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है. सबसे पहले इसको खत्म करना पड़ता है. आपको धीरे धीरे समझना होता है कि मैं जैसा कुछ है ही नहीं. आप छोटे से जर्रा है पूरे यूनिवर्स में, लेकिन आपके लिए आप पूरी यूनिवर्स है. बट फिलोसफी हमको यही समझाती है दैट हाउ यू आर रिलेटेड टू एंटायर यूनिवर्स. यू माइट थिंक दैट योर एक्शन हैज नॉट अ ह्यूज इम्प्लीकेशन और रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन अ सोसाइटी, बट ट्रस्ट मी, यूर अ पार्ट ऑफ अ सोसाइटी. वॉट एवर वी डू, इट हैज क्लियर कनेक्शन विद आर सोसाइटी. सो इट इज रियली इम्पॉर्टेंट टू हैव ह्यूमैनिटी विद इन अस, टू हैव कॉन्शियसनेस विद इन अस. And as Socrates have said that it has to be protected, and it has to be, you know, we have to cultivate it, we have to work on it. So aapko usko nurture karna padta hai. Okay, baar baar aapko contemplate karna padta hai, baar baar aapko apne aap ko samajhna hai ki aap sahi kar rahe hain, galat kar rahe hain. You need to study. So ye how you can have morality? Definitely by reading. Okay, so knowing what is good is the same as doing what is good. Believe people would not willing to do wrong. No one wants to be a bad person. Later philosophers would disagree with him. They said that a person might know what is right, but may not be strong enough or disciplined enough to do. This is also correct. So we know this is right, this is wrong. We often see that we are addicted to lot many things, you know, smoking, we are addicted to lie, lot many things. So we know that waking up early in the morning is good, doing good thing is really good for our health, but we cannot do it. So definitely it requires lot of discipline. Okay, so you need to really be watchful towards your habits. So similarly of alcohol, we know that he talks about alcohol. So drunkenness, only short time pleasure is gain. Whatever you are escaping from when you drink will come back. So drunkenness has long term effects, leads to ill health, can enslave the body. This is what I personally don't like. You know, your hobby, any person, your emotions, they should not govern you. You should be the masters of your desires. You should control your life. आपकी लाइफ में वही होना चाहिए जो आप चाहते हो. दैट्स मीन यू नीड टू बिकम सुई जनरस, यू नीड टू बिकम वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग सो दैट द एक्सटर्नल सिचुएशंस व्हाटसोएवर इट इज अराउंड इन योर लाइफ शुड नॉट इम्पैक्ट यू नेगेटिवली. ओके, सो यू नीड टू प्रोसेस इट. इफ देर आर फ्यू इंडिविजुअल्स इन योर लाइफ, फ्यू योर जॉब्स, योर वर्क, योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, you need to understand them, and then you need to have a control over it. So definitely there are some circumstances us pe aapka control nahi hai, but usko aapko respond kaise karna hai, kaise uska impact aapko negative na kare, aapke liye danger na ho, wo aapko seekhna padega. And how it come? It can only come through good meditation, control, and see what you are doing in your life. Okay, so rest that you do not have to become slave of anyone. So this is what he simply talk about drinking. So Socrates believes true pleasure could only be attained through living a moral life. So by 399 BC, Socrates was being executed. So Athens was in danger of destruction, became critical of the government. He was social and moral critic. He attempted to improve the Athenian sense of justice. His pursuit of virtue and his strict adherence to truth clashed with Athenian society. He claimed he was the wiser one, since he was the only person aware of his own ignorance. So put on trial and found guilty. And you know, he had the chance to escape his execution, but he decided not to escape and drank the position and died. Okay, so these are the fundamental points of Socrates. You can later on understand that how Socrates' ideas was then implemented by Plato, but this is what we can say about Socrates. Okay, and we can summarize Socrates' ideas. So he was talking about what is the most important point is, it is knowledge, virtue. Life should be spent in search of goodness. So you have to be morally correct. So truth is possible to achieve, definitely. People should focus on self-development rather than material wealth. So it is a job of the philosopher to show people how little they really know. And action is right when it promotes true happiness. Okay, so this is what Socrates have said. Even the Socrates and Plato have this point that who should govern the world? He says that philosophers should rule the world. Okay, so morality, happiness, honesty, truthfulness, it should not only be the part of your UPSC syllabus, where you will just read it for the sake of writing good essays or in ethics. It should become part of your life. Okay, because the more better person you will become, the more positive energy will attract you. You will become more positive person, optimistic. You will see a great sense of energy in you. You will find that your thought process, you will find in your thought process, if you are very clear that you do not have anything to do with negativity around you. In fact, if you will be able to train yourself, automatically you will get into that stage where you will avoid persons, events, or any situation that can drain your energy, which is actually an obstacle for your development, your economic development. Just imagine, that life, we are living in a contemporary society. We are living in a highly competitive society. You really have to be on your toes with wisdom. So, mantra kya hai success ka? Pehle to aapko apne aapko negative cheezon se dur rakhni hai. Aur agar aapne apne aapko train kara, to aap automatically select karne lag jaoge ki haan, ye mere liye important nahi hai. I want to become an IAS officer. I want to achieve my goals. Aur spending my time with this person or that person who are negative or who is draining your time, you will start avoiding them. And when you start avoiding them, for that, it is really important to identify it. Okay, so eventually what Socrates have said, that what should be the goal of your life, it has to be morality. And do not think that morality is something which will distract you from your goals, from your material goals. No, if you are a moral person, if you are a good person who have a control over thought process, desires, who do not think bad, it will actually save your energy, which you can later on put on your work, your job, your goals, and that actually will help you to grow. You will see it. Okay? Thank you. I hope you like my lecture on Socrates.